At this time, I would like to briefly mention and elaborate on some of the programs that I mentioned earlier. The STEM program, the library, and the building, and the expansion, and all of these projects, mashallah, that we have underway. Our focus is going to be for this year to be able to not only strengthen the lower elementary and the upper elementary grades, but also to be able to enrich our middle school program quite a bit. So in order for us to be able to do that, we are going to, inshallah, be moving our early childhood program to a facility that was recently acquired, which was next to RCM. Mashallah, the facility is ideally designed for the early childhood students with their own bathroom facility at their level, their own sinks for art and play activities, large classrooms, direct access to a playground from each individual classrooms. It's an amazing opportunity for us to be able to move our students to that building so that they can have the attention and the programs and be able to expand upon what we are already doing for them. But additionally, if we move our early childhood program across the street, then what it will do is it'll allow us room, additional room, to be able to offer programs and services that are directly focused on improving and enriching the upper elementary and the middle school students. So this will give us the room to have a science lab, inshallah. This will give us the room to add a library, and this will give us the room to be able to incorporate and introduce the STEM program. To that end, I just want to identify some of the steps that we've already taken, because we mentioned this several months ago at the open house that these were our ideas, but I want all of us to be aware that we have already started mobilizing in bringing that as a reality by August. So we've already hired Dr. Pervez Iqbal, who is going to be the math and science department chair and the STEM program coordinator. We've already sent about 4 to 5 staff members, including him, to STEM training program in Minnesota for 2 days this month. So the ball is already rolling as far as the STEM program is concerned. We're already making room for for us to be able to expand on our science program, enrich our math program, be able to offer library services for our students. And from the library itself, it's not just a matter of the students going in, checking out a book, and reading it. We can have an accelerated reading program. We can have an accelerated math program. We can have a writing curriculum and program. We can have authors that are invited to the school. So all of these are going to be programs that are going to be coming out as a result of having a library. So we are already working in that direction. Inshallah, we hope to achieve much of that before the first day of school on August 12th. And I'd like to invite Dr. Ryan to be able to elaborate on that. Dr. Ryan has been involved with ILM Academy since 2012. He has 2 sons enrolled in the school. He grew up in St. Louis, Missouri, and attended much of his time in the public school system. He and his wife came to Atlanta in 2003 so he could complete medical school. He is a firm believer in quality Islamic education and feels that it is the best thing that we can give to our children. It is for this reason his kids attend ILM Academy. He is eager to implement a school culture where parents can combine their efforts to provide their children with the best education available. And he would just like a few minutes of your time to present the initiatives for next year and elaborate on that, inshallah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salam, Rahman ar-Rahim. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. First of all, on behalf of ILM Academy and PTO and everyone here, we'd like to thank you all for coming this morning and joining us at the graduation ceremony for 2015. I wanted you guys to realize that it takes a lot of effort to put on such a school year with all these programs and other imaginative ideas for instruction. And the reason why it works so well here is because of our teachers, administrators, PTO, because of Sister Farhat and her efforts. Without these people, none of this would happen. We wouldn't have as interesting classrooms. We wouldn't have these ilmathon and what have you throughout the year to show our kids how much fun this is and how much fun this can be. So really, I think we should all take a second and give share a round of applause for all the teachers Thank you, teachers. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you very much. It's awesome. We all appreciate everything you've done all year long and in the past. Inshallah, going forward, you'll continue to offer our children the same kind of efforts you've been doing, and we will all continue to appreciate all of your efforts, inshallah. May Allah bless you guys all. There's no way else to say it. We cannot repay you for what you are giving to our children. So the board has asked me to step up this morning and kind of give you guys an idea of what's going on, where we're heading, where we are now. Let me first tell you about where we are now. Alhamdulillah, you guys remember a year and a half ago, we weren't even anywhere close to sitting in a room like this. Now here we are. Fast forward 18 months, and here we are inside this nicely air-conditioned building, dealing with everything else is working in here. We actually, the past few months, we put in this computer lab upstairs in a one-story building. Does anyone think it's kind of weird? I did. I was like, how can you guys put a second story in a one-story building? MashaAllah, we did it here. We have had our fair share of trials and tribulations. Despite all that, MashaAllah, we were able to persevere, put forth the effort, put forth the money, the resources we needed to make this school as good as it is now. Now, a lot of people come up to me and said, what is in the pipeline for Ilm Academy? Yeah, all right, pipeline. First thing in the pipeline has walking across the stage this morning. I've seen at least 120 kids so far. That is our pipeline. I'm really excited about it. My 3 years here at Ilm Academy, I've never once attended a graduation ceremony yet. It's because after school is over, my family is on a plane somewhere else. We're heading somewhere. But this year, we were able to make it so that we can be here, and this is awesome. I really enjoyed watching our children perform for us this morning. So along those lines, this is what we're looking for. This is the goal. The goal is to make all these kids that walk across the stage this morning into productive members of society, devoted to Allah. So How are we going to continue to do that? We're going to have to continue to improve ourselves. Now, Allah commanded us when we do things, to do everything with ihsan. Now, along those lines, in my personal life, I'm never comfortable with maintaining status quo. I can't do it. And whatever it is, I'm not going to say, okay, I'm good, I'm going to cruise. No. I always want to improve. Maintaining status quo for me is not an option. Now, I joined the board recently with three other members. One of them is Samir Ahmed behind the camera, Samir Sheikh's in the corner, and Brother Amir Ahmed is sitting right there. The four of us recently joined the board of directors for Ilm Academy. We all got the same goal. We're all going to continue to improve. Now, what's the next step? So Tafar has mentioned the two next steps. The STEM program. We're gonna unroll a STEM program this next school year, inshallah. STEM, for those of you who don't know, is the new cutting-edge methodology in academia. So all the new schools that are doing well are advertising their STEM programs. So the question arises, what is STEM program? Yeah, STEM program, science, technology, engineering, and math. These are what these people have determined is the most important subjects. Yeah, no kidding. So anyway, we're going to really try and emphasize science, technology, education, engineering and math. Now, in order to be qualified, or in order to fulfill the requirements to be called a STEM school, we need to have a few more things set up. We already have one thing. One important thing was to have a principal. We have that now, alhamdulillah. Another thing we had to do was to have the building and certain things. But a few additions we don't have is a library. A STEM school has to have a library. Also, a STEM school has to have a STEM lab. We don't have that either. Now, how are we going to get a STEM lab? How are we going to get a library within 2.5 months before school starts? Well, the way it's going to happen is from us here in this room to reach into our pockets and pull out some money. Really, it is. We have a limited amount of resources, but with what resources we have, collectively, we can accomplish a lot. Does anyone know what a laser is? A laser is simply a light. There's lights all over here. How come these lights aren't lasers? Because they aren't focused in one direction. Okay? Laser is a light focused in one direction. Now, that one laser can cut through metal, can cut through thick plastic, can cut through glass. Can this light cut through glass? No, of course not. Why? It's not focused in one direction. It's going every which way. Now, what if we collectively take all of our efforts and combine it and put it into one direction? How much could we accomplish? Inshallah. That's what I want to do. That's what I want to see from consistently. I bet the 120 families in this school, I bet if we combine our efforts, we can do a lot. MashaAllah, so far we've done this much. I know a lot of you guys are impressed. I really am. Whenever I come here, I look around, wow, MashaAllah, I can't believe this is here. How did Allah do this? How did we do this with almost nothing a couple years ago? Now imagine coming in here 2 more years later and seeing the science lab and seeing the STEM lab and seeing the library and seeing the school across the street. How are we going to feel? Wow, alhamdulillah, who did this? How did it happen? It was the parents. We were the ones. We were the ones who were sitting here. We were the steadfast in our beliefs. We just maintain the course. We're not comfortable with maintaining status quo. No. I know no one here is comfortable maintaining status quo. Now, to that end, let's see. I've actually did some research. It looks to me like it's going to cost about $20,000 to install, have a nice library in here that would qualify us for STEM. I did some more research, and it sounds like it's going to cost between $40,000, $45,000 to have a STEM lab installed in school. The STEM lab, of course, is going to have the science stuff like the gas, Bunsen burners. It's going to have the robotic stuff and all that set up so that we can call ourselves a STEM school and offer STEM curriculum. So it sounds to me like if you add the 20 for a library, add a 45 for the STEM lab, we're going to need about $65,000 in the next few months. And if we can get that, we can have these installed before next school year. Next school year, seriously, is August. It will take no time before August is rolling around. And if we have not collected the money required to put these things in, guess what? They won't be here. That would really dampen my plan. I got to tell you that the board of directors have asked me to stand in for Imad Sabah, who was the previous fundraising chairman or director. Now it's gonna be me. My first goal is gonna be to try to get this library and STEM lab installed before the school year. So I need to see if anybody in here can help us get close to 65 grand. I know a lot of us in here have got 10 grand laying around. Anybody here can say, you know what, I got it. I got 10 grand, I got 1/6 of your cost. Please, anybody. I tell you what, I got an idea. I got a better idea. Yes, awesome, Umar. I got a better idea. What we're gonna do before Ramadan, the Board of Governors and I are going to set up a initiative, both online campaign as well as phone and brochures about this new program, about our STEM program, about how are we going to go about collecting the money to put this together. Okay, it's going to be the next few weeks, and I need all of us who are here now to tell everyone else, everyone in your classes, everyone else that goes into school, all your other friends who are in the area. Look, Elm Academy is trying to do this for our children. Please help us out. If all of us in the school ask our friends to help us out with our children, there is no stopping us. No doubt. If all of us ask our friends, hey, look, man, my child attends Ilm Academy, and they need this much money. We got this much. Can you help? All of us will be able to collect funds for this school. Now imagine how much effort it takes for one guy to stand up on stage and ask for so much money, or how much effort from one Imad Sabah does it take to put together a school, put together these walls. A lot of effort. Now what if we all take some of that burden away? Say, you know what, I can help you, Dr. Ryan, I can help you, Imad. I'm going to go ask my neighbors, I'm going to go ask my Kala, my Taya, whatever you, what have you, my Nana. I'm going to ask them for some money, and we're going to all put it together. Focus our light like a laser and fire. Inshallah, that's my plan. So before Ramadan, we're going to have this campaign set up. We're gonna try and send it out with email, slow mail, all that stuff so we can get your attention. After we get your attention, please go out and tell your friends, this is what we're trying to do. We're trying to open STEM lab and a library. Two tangible goals, which we can see, touch, feel, taste next year if you want to taste it. It'll be there. Science, STEM lab, library, about $65,000, and we can do this. We can have it for our children next year, school year, inshallah. That's all I have. Anything else? Oh, the pledge forms are been floating around. Please, if you can't give the money right now, you can say, hey, before school starts, I'm going to contribute this much money. Here's my pledge form. I'll be equally happy for that. Please find a pledge form, fill it out, and hand it to me or one of the other board members. Also, when we do contact you about the initiative in the next few weeks, make sure you ask all your friends to help out. Inshallah. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.
Jazakallah khair. Just to break it down, I think we have about 150 students and maybe about 70 plus families or so. To make it very easy, if we make the intention of giving $1,000 every family, I think we'll achieve the goal. And if you want to wait 2 weeks and earn extra credit and do it in Ramadan, I think that should be okay. You'll get 70 times more ajr, inshallah, for it. But if every one of us, and I know all of us donate more than $1,000 in Ramadan, so if one of those thousands can be for Ilm Academy, for your kids, and for the future of the Muslim Ummah in this country, then please do so, inshallah. And it will be with you forever, the ajr and the benefit in this world and the hereafter. Jazakallah khair.